more, grace did much more abound. Friend, it's not that the devil is short on numbers. It's just that God has him outnumbered. Hallelujah. It's not that sin, amen, is short in numbers. It's that grace has a lot more in numbers. Glory to God. And so I want to preach tonight on much more. Amen. Sin abounded, but grace did much more abound. We need the grace of God, church. We need the grace of God in our life. We need the grace of God in our home and in our family and in our souls. The Bible tells us in Acts chapter number 15 and verse number 11, we believe that through the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, we shall be saved. Hallelujah. For the grace of God, for there it is, we see the need for grace. The Bible tells us in Ephesians chapter 2 and verse number 5, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace are you saved. Verse number 8 of the same chapter, for by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Praise God for grace tonight. Amen. The need of grace is seen right here. Romans chapter 3 and verse number 24, the Bible said, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. Amen. And in the book of Titus chapter number 3 and verse number 7, the Bible says that being justified by his grace, we should be made heirs according to the hope of eternal life. And then the very familiar scripture is in Titus 2 and verse number 11, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared unto all men. And so sin is everywhere. I know that I don't have to get on a rampage tonight about sin. Amen. I don't have to get today's paper, amen, up here and read it for us to realize, amen, sin is abounding all around us. Everywhere you look, sin is growing. There's not a shortage of sin. Amen. There may be a shortage on corn, or there may be a shortage on wheat. Amen. But there's not a shortage on sin. Amen. And so the Bible here says where sin abounded, grace did much more abound. God's grace is greater than sin. Friend, it's important for us to realize, amen, that light is greater than darkness. Amen. It's important for us to realize that love is greater than hate. Amen. It's important for us to realize, amen, and know without a shadow of a doubt that God is greater than the devil. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness tonight? Amen. We got to realize, amen, that God's grace, amen, is much more. Can somebody say much more? Much more. Sin's abounding, but grace did much more abound. Hallelujah. We got a lot of sin, but we got a whole lot more grace. God's grace. We know the song, Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound, that saved a wretch like me. I would like to preach about grace tonight. I know this is Sunday night, and I said I've already felt the presence of God here tonight. I've enjoyed the testimonies, and I don't believe that God's done. And if y'all will just hold with me for a little while, I want to preach for just a little while on much more. If y'all just join in with me right here and realize that there's much more grace, hallelujah, than there is sin. Amen. God's not ran out of grace. Hallelujah. Just like the world ain't ran out of sin. Amen. There's sin on every hand, but there's grace of God. Amen. That's more. It's in more abundance than sin. Where sin abounded, grace did much more abound. I know there's abounding, amen, sin, but there's abounding grace, and it is much more. I want to talk to us about, amen, two things about grace. I want to talk to us about the riches of grace. Amen. I'm preaching on much more. And I want to talk about the reign of grace, the authority of grace, the power of grace. Amen. Grace has more power than sin. Hallelujah. You're talking about power of sin. Sin has got power. It's got a grip. Amen. On people. Hallelujah. They're bound with the grip of sin. Amen. They may even want loose, but they can't get loose. Amen. There's a grip of sin. But friend, there's a grip of grace too. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And grace can get a hold of us and can keep us through many dangers, toils, and snares. Now I look back on my life and I've only been saved for 25 years. Amen. And the saints of God have served the Lord for years and been through trials and been through tests and been through storms, sister. Amen. When we look back on our lives, sometimes we think, man, how did I make it through? But we hear songs like, "The anchor holds." Glory to God. The anchor holds tonight. Thank God. There is, amen, a grip of grace. Glory to God. There's riches of grace. God's not short, amen, on grace tonight. Hallelujah. I'm preaching on much more. Riches. Glory to God. People's got riches. Amen. People's got, you know, bank accounts. People's got money. People's got gold. Amen. Hallelujah. There's all type of investments. Amen. But you know what? God's rich in grace. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us in Ephesians chapter 1 and verse number 7, "In whom we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of His grace." Redemption through His blood. Money can't buy redemption. Amen. Money can't buy us back. Glory to God. I've told the story, amen, and I know, amen, some of y'all have probably heard it about the little boy that made that little boat, had that little sailboat, and he bought that little kit, amen, he made that little boat, and he painted that little boat, amen, and he made it just the way he wanted it, and fixed it up just right. He puts it out on the little creek, somebody said creek, creek, whatever, amen, puts it out there, and he's floating it down through there, and he loses it, it gets away from him, amen, he looks, and he can't find it. Amen. One day, several weeks later, he's in a store and he sees that boat. Amen. In a resale store. He sees the boat. He said, "That's my boat. I made that boat. I know it's mine." He looked it over. That's mine. Maybe he had his initials on it. I'm not sure. But he goes to that man who owned that resale store and he said, "This is my boat." He said, "I made this boat. And a few weeks ago, I was out and I was floating this boat down the creek." And he said, "It got away, but this is my boat." And that man looked at him and he said, "That might have been your boat." And he said, "But it's my boat now." And he said, "If you want it, you'll have to buy it." Amen. Whatever the price was, you know, $4.25 or whatever. It was too much money for him to buy. He couldn't buy it. And so he goes and he mows yards and he sells newspapers. He does everything he can. He saves money. He goes back and he buys the boat. Come on, church. Hallelujah. Amen. And when he walks out of the store, the man hears him say, "Now you're twice mine. I made you and I bought you." Hallelujah. Now I want to tell you, church, the Lord made us. Sin separated us. Amen. But now we're twice His. He made us and He bought us. Glory to God. Sin took us away down the stream from God. Can I get a witness tonight? I'm going to tell you something. Grace is God's unmerited favor. We don't deserve the grace of God tonight. We don't deserve to be saved. We don't deserve to be in His presence. Amen. But where sin abounded, grace did much more abound. God's rich in grace. Hallelujah. He's got enough grace for everyone. God can turn it around for us. Amen. God's got the power to turn it around. He can turn it around for our family. Amen. Somebody said, "Well, they may have gone too far." They haven't gone too far for the grace of God. The grace of God reaches to the ends of the earth. It reaches to the darkest dungeon and the darkest prison. Amen. It reaches to the highest mountain and it flows to the lowest valley. Hallelujah. For the grace of God, God is rich in grace. Maybe somebody here tonight, you're facing something. You're facing something. Hallelujah. I know some of you is facing something. I know about it. Amen. God's got enough grace for us. Hallelujah. Yes. I said God's not got enough grace for us. Oh, hallelujah. He's not pouring grace tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. They tell the story of a preacher in England back in the 40s and said that he told his church, he said, "Y'all," he said, "I want to try something." He said, "I want you," he said, if you'll do this with me, I want you to meet with me after church." He said, "I want us to find the worst man we know or the worst person we know." He said, "I want us to begin to pray for them and talk to them about the Lord and see what the Lord does in their life." The preacher said, "I only had six." It was a very large church. He said, "I only had six people that would join with me," and said, "We'll try this experience. He was going to try it and see what happened. And he said, so they all agreed that they would find or think of the worst person that they know, and they would begin to pray for this person to be saved and begin to talk to them about the Lord. He said he went home that night and he said he thought, "You know, I told them to do it." He said, "I'm going to do that." He said, I'm going to join in with them. He said, that'll be seven of us. I'm going to do this. He said something to his wife. His wife said, well, who's the worst person you know? He said, you know, I don't know. He said, I don't run in those levels. He said, I really don't know. He said, most of my acquaintances are good people. And she said, well, how are you going to do this then? He said, I don't know. He said, so the thought come to him, well, just kind of go over on the bad side of town and find out. See if you can find out the worst person. See if you can find who has the worst reputation. Said he goes over there in an area, the bad side, and I don't want to bore y'all tonight. I'm preaching on much more grace. Hallelujah. God's got much more grace. Said he goes over on the bad side, you know, and I said, who's the worst person over here? They said, oh, it's that man that lives right down there. Said, you know, down there. So he goes down there and knocks on the door. He said, sir, I'm a preacher. And he said, I was told you was the worst man over here. He said, you go find the person that told you that, and I'll show them, amen, who the worst person is. He said, the worst person is the man down here. So he goes down there where he told him to go. He knocked on the door. He said, sir, I'm a preacher. And he said, I'm looking for somebody with a bad reputation. He said, I'm looking for the worst person in the world. He said, they told me that you was. He said, man, I can't believe that. He said, everybody in this area knows that the worst person in the world is so-and-so. Well, where does he live? He lives so, but such and such place. And the story is, amen, he said, I went to that house and I knocked on the door. Nobody came. He said, I knocked again and I heard some shuffling. Somebody opened the door real quiet. He said, I said, I'm the preacher for such and such church. And I'm looking for the worst man in the world. He said, the man began to weep and cry. He said, I'm the worst man in the world. I just told my wife, I am the worst man in the world. He said, you did? He said, yes, sir. He said, come in. Oh, God help us. I'm talking about the grace of God. He said, I walked in there and his wife standing there and he said, honey, tell this preacher what I just said. She said, what are you talking about? I said, tell him what I said about myself. I said, well, you just said you was the worst person in the world. Come to find out, he was an alcoholic and he was tired of sinning and he couldn't get loose and all this. And he had broken down right before the preacher had knocked on the door, mind you. He had broken down and said, honey, amen, I am the worst person in the world. And if nobody will help me, I'm going to go drown myself in the river. Amen. The preacher said, I come to tell you, God loves you. Amen. Let's get on our knees. The story is, Sister Janice, that he got on his knees and he prayed through and became a faithful member of the church, served God. Why? Amen. Sin was abounding, but God's grace, hallelujah, grace does much more abound. Amen. We fight sin. Amen. Sin gets a hold of us. Glory to God. Sin will cause us to be broken poor. Amen. But God is rich in grace. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us in Ephesians 2:7, that the ages to come might show the exceeding riches of his grace. Exceeding, glory to God. Abundant. Amen. Abounding. God's grace abounds. Listen, there's hope for our families. There's hope for our children. There's hope for our loved ones. There's hope for your husband, your wife. Amen. There's hope, I'm telling you, because God's still rich in grace. Woo! All God has to do, amen, is show forth his mighty power and save. Show the exceeding riches of his grace and his kindness toward us through Christ Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Titus chapter number 3 and verse number 6, the Bible says, which he shed on us abundantly through Christ Jesus, our Savior. Abundantly. It fills the earth. It's enough. Glory to God. In the book of Timothy, and I'm moving quickly tonight, I'm preaching on much more, the riches of his grace. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And in 1 Timothy chapter number 1, verse number 12, he said, I thank Christ Jesus, our Lord, who hath enabled me that he counted me faithful, putting me in the ministry, who was before a blasphemer and a persecutor and an injurious, but I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly in unbelief. And the grace of our Lord Jesus, of our Lord, was exceeding abundant with faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus. Glory to God. This is a faithful saving and worthy of all acceptation. that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. Glory to God. Amen. Listen to this. Abundantly. Exceeding abundant. Sounds like much more to me, don't it you? Sounds like God's got plenty of grace tonight. Hallelujah. God's got enough grace. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He's rich in grace. Thank God. Glory to God. Amen. Talking about the riches of God. Praise the Lord. The riches of God. Romans 2 and 4 says the riches of His goodness. Romans 9 and 23 says the riches of His glory. Hallelujah. Philippians 4 and 19, we all know that. But my God shall supply all your need according to His riches in glory. Woo! Riches in glory. How many riches does He have? Thank God, the riches of His grace. Let's talk about the reign of His grace. The power of His grace. The authority of His grace. 100% control. Glory to God. What are you controlled by? Controlled by the grace of God. Hallelujah. God's grace can control us and keep us. And keep us saved. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I'm telling you something right now, church. God can control you. God can get a hold of you and control you. He can keep you saved. Young people, the grace of God can keep you saved. Hallelujah. Just like I've already mentioned, through many dangers, toils, and snares. Amen. I was raised by a godly family. Amen. And praying mom and dad. And cut my teeth on the church pew, so to speak. Amen. Slept under the pews like many of these children. Amen. And went to church. Somebody said, I had a drug problem when I was a kid. I was drugged to church, drugged to revival, drugged to Sunday school. I was drugged. That was my drug problem. But anyways, amen. You know, raised there in McCurtain County, Oklahoma. I'm talking about drug capital, marijuana everywhere. Amen. I remember those young people, you know, and I want y'all to know it's the grace of God that kept me. Amen. I never drank beer. I never smoked cigarettes. Amen. I never done those things. You say, well, it's because you was raised. Hey, listen. Amen. I don't know if they'd want me to tell it, but my brothers can't all say those things. I know they're preachers, but they can't say all those things if they never smoked cigarettes and that they never drank beer and they never done those things. We was raised by the same family. Come on, we know that it don't always turn out that way. Hallelujah. It don't always work out just the same way. And I give it all the glory to God tonight. I said I give it all the glory to God. I remember, hallelujah, as a young person, amen, that craving for that cigarette. Come on, where'd that come from? Mom and dad wasn't shoving it in my face or blowing it in my face. Come on, church, y'all help me. Amen. Hallelujah. That craving come. And those boys from the neighborhood offered me one, and I wanted it. It was the devil. Amen. But you know what? God kept me in that time. And now, looking back, it was the grace of God. Hallelujah. And God's grace kept me. I remember we was over. Amen. Nobody else was around. And we was over there around this. There was a, God help me tonight, Jesus. Help me, Lord. Tonight, Lord. We was around, there was this old, you know, this old road and had this, you know, big old culvert, and we could walk. We, you know, we was small enough and that thing was real tall, Brother Richard. We could walk under it. Those boys was in there smoking marijuana. They was my friends. Amen. I never smoked marijuana. Amen. I was raised by godly people, but I was over and nobody was around. Amen. And I remember something about it, just wanting to try it. Amen. But God kept me. Hallelujah. This may not stir you tonight, but we live in a world of sin. We don't know where our children's going to turn. Amen. But I'm telling you, young people, God's grace can keep you. He can keep you saved. He can keep you from sin. He can keep you from sexual sins. He can keep you from dark spirits and evil. Amen. It has a grip. There's a reign of grace. Not only riches of grace, there's a reign of grace. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness tonight? Amen. There's the grace of God that can get a hold of you. Paul said, amen, not that I have apprehended, but amen, but I have. Let me read it to you in Philippians, because it say, what he's saying is, I got a hold of what has got a hold of me. Glory to God. In Philippians 3, not that I have already attained, neither were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that which also I am apprehended of. Brother Wayne, you know what the Apostle Paul is saying? Stand up, come up here. Amen, and get a hold of me. Amen, embrace me. Hallelujah, glory to God. Paul is saying, something's got a hold of me, and I got a hold of what has got a hold of me. Hallelujah. The Apostle Paul said, amen, that I may apprehend what I am apprehended of. What the Apostle Paul is saying, sister, is I can get a hold of what has got a hold to me. Now I want to tell you, something's got a hold to me. Glory to God. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get a hold of what's got a hold to me. Young people, you know what you got to do? You got to get a hold of what's got a hold of you. Church, we got to get a hold of what's got a hold of us. The grace of God has got a hold of us. Hallelujah. Woo! The grace of God has got a hold of us. Thank God. And I got a hold of the grace of God too. 100% control. The reign of grace. Hallelujah, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. I'm almost through. I'm preaching on much more. Can somebody say much more? Amen. Listen to this. 1 John chapter 5, verse 9. If we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody say greater. Woo! Amen. For this is the witness of God, which he hath testified of his Son. He that believeth on the Son hath the witness in himself. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. I'm going to tell you all about something. Amen. I was down there in Dallas going to some training for the school. And I know I've told some of y'all this. Amen. But I was in there and I walked in. We had been in class all day and I walked in. They had this big old clear container. And I didn't know it was alcohol. I didn't know. And I'm not saying I was condemned to hell or complete awful sinner if I'd have drank that. I thought it was apple juice. I really did. And God knows my heart. I'm not ashamed to tell you. I thought it was apple juice. Y'all don't think this is funny. Some of y'all are. And it is kind of funny. I went over there and I filled me a big old, you know, this little video glass. Filled me a big old drink of it. I pulled that thing and I filled it up. Never once. I thought it was apple juice and I was thirsty. Amen. I've thought about this over and over. Amen. I was completely oblivious. I can't believe I said that big word. I was completely oblivious. I said it again. Hallelujah. Of what was going on. I had no idea. And this is the truth. I filled that thing up. I never smelt it. Nothing. And I was coming like right here. And I want y'all to know, God, about right here, something hit me in the heart. Nobody was watching. I didn't even know. I thought it was apple juice. Something hit me in the heart. It was the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost checked me. And I looked at that. And I looked again. Never smelled it. And I said, hey. And it's still in my pea little brain. I still didn't think, well, this is alcohol. I couldn't just smell it. No, it was alcohol. I said, hey. He looked over. I said, is this apple juice? He said, no, that's whatever, Coors Light or Bud Light or something. My Lord. And I went over and preached him a whole message. I'm telling you the truth, I did. And those people that were with me, they knew it. Praise God. What is it? It's the grip of grace. I want y'all to know the truth. Amen. I don't believe, you know, that if I had drank that, you know, my conscience was clean. I didn't know it was alcohol. I'm not saying I'd immediately been a sinner or condemned to hell. But I know one thing. I sure thank God for the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Young people, you don't have to sin. They'll offer you this or offer you that. I'm telling you, there's a lot of people that's bound by sin that wish they'd have never had the first drink. Can I get a witness tonight? They wish they'd have never had the first smoke. Can I get a witness tonight? Amen. I'm talking about the grip of grace, young people, that can get a hold of your heart and keep you through every dark hour in your life. The Bible said, he that believeth on the Son of God hath the witness in himself. Amen. That he believeth not, he that believeth not, God hath made him a liar because he believeth not the record that God gave of his Son. And this is the record, amen, that God hath given us to eternal life. given us to eternal life, and this life is in His Son. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son hath not life. Woo! Amen. I've got the Son of God tonight living in my heart. And it's His grace that's brought Him to me. Thank you, Jesus. Complete control. 100% control of God. Amen. Very familiar scriptures, and I'm almost done. Hallelujah. I'm talking about the reign of grace tonight. Let God reign in your life. Let the Holy Ghost reign in your life. Praise God. John chapter number 8, verse 34. The Bible says, Jesus answered in them, verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever committeth sin is the servant of sin. The servant abideth not in the house forever, but the Son abideth forever. If the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. Hallelujah. Glory to God, if the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. God's grace does much more abound. Sin is everywhere, young people, but the grace of God is greater, and there's a whole lot more grace than there is sin. Control. Stand together with me tonight. Hallelujah, Jesus. Let's just worship the Lord just a moment right now. Somebody here needs the grace of God in your life. You need the power of God in your life. The touch of God in your life.